Hi everyone, Petrik here. For today's video, it will be a top 10 list, and this will be a top 10 completed fantasy trilogy that I've read so far. And so far, I've read 45. Yeah, I've read 45 completed fantasy trilogies. There are still other completed fantasy trilogies that I haven't read or I haven't finished. And of course, I'm still in the middle of so many series right now. But in the meantime, I have finished 45 completed fantasy trilogy. That's a lot of books. That's 135 books. That's quite a lot. At the end of last year, I did a top 15 completed fantasy series of all time as of 2020. So I thought about updating that video, but I think it might be better for me to read more completed fantasy series first before I update that list again. So I think that list, the top 15 completed fantasy series, I think I will do another video like that next year. I'm not putting any rule on this list except that it's a completed fantasy trilogy that I've read. Oh, and also, it must not be a sequel trilogy. So for example, of Blood and Bone trilogy by John Gwynn. That's the second series in the Banishland saga that takes place after The Faithful and the Fallen. So I won't include that on this list because I think that kind of sequel trilogy has a lot of enhancements from their previous series, so I won't be including that on this list. And plus, a lot of people have been requesting me for my list of completed fantasy trilogy because 3 are usually a good number to be reading fantasy series because it's not too long and it's also not too short. It's a good number. So I totally understand, and yeah, so this is my list. At the number 10 spot, it is The Lifeship Traders by Robin Hobb. I know I just talk about not including a sequel series on this list, but I think I will have to make an exception just for The Lifeship Traders because The Lifeship Traders work absolutely well as a starting point in the realm of the Elderlings. So if you don't read Farseer Trilogy and you just jump immediately into The Lifeship Traders, you will be able to enjoy it immensely. I think you will be enjoyed to the fullest. Yeah, seriously. There is a cameo appearance in The Lifeship Traders, but somehow quite a lot of people doesn't know about that particular character appearing until they've read the sequel to this one, the Tony Man trilogy. So yeah, I highly recommend The Lifeship Traders. I, as a fantasy reader, don't usually like a fantasy series that focuses so much on seafaring or naval warfare, but Robin Hobb, her characterizations are always at the top of the game. Seriously, Robin Hobb is a master at characterizations. And I think The Lifeship Traders, in my opinion, it is the second best series in all the entire realm of the Elderlings. The best one being the final one, The Fits and the Fool. That one is an absolute masterpiece. Yeah. So I highly recommend The Lifeship Traders, and this is at my number 10 spot. And then at the number 9 spot, it is The Winnowing Flame trilogy by Jen Williams. So this one is one of the most underrated trilogy of all time, in my opinion. It is still underrated to this day. It is unbelievable. Unbelievable. Characterizations, aerial battles, animal companions, and a believable and lovable romance. Yes, Jen Williams has it all in the Winnowing Flame trilogy. And recently, Elliot Brooks has been talking about this series so much, and I'm truly happy because this series, as I said, deserves so much more recognition. Even right now, the Winnowing Flame trilogy is still not published in the US. That is insane. That is insane. Seriously, US publisher, what are you doing? Sign this trilogy. Orbit Books, if you're watching this, do it. Seriously, this series is incredible. The first book, The Ninth Rain, was already incredible, and then the second book, it was also so good. But then the third book, it was the best of the trilogy. It was so good. It was amazing. It concluded the series magnificently. Jen Williams also combined fantasy, sci-fi, and horror into this one trilogy, and it is amazing. It is amazing. Seriously, give this a try. If you're in the US or you're an international reader, you can get this book from Blackwell's or maybe from Book Depository. Both of them have free shipping almost worldwide, and I think you should check them out. And then the next series on this list is the Poppy War trilogy by R.F. Kuang. I have talked about this series so many times now. It is one of the best Grimdark series that I've read so far. And R.F. Kuang, in my opinion, is an author to watch out for. Ever since I've read the Poppy War, I already thought that this author, she will be big in the future. And yeah, she's getting more and more popular now. I think it's all well deserved. The Poppy War, The Dragon Republic, and The Burning God, all of them are amazing, especially The Burning God. The Burning God is my favorite book of the trilogy. It was so good. It's heartbreaking, it's emotional, and it's also so brutal. And then the next series on this list is the Divine Series Trilogy by Robert Jackson Bennett. Again, I think Robert Jackson Bennett is an incredibly underrated author. I think he deserves so much more audience because he's doing a lot of great things in fantasy right now. And this is not just in the Divine Series Trilogy, but also in his Foundry Side Trilogy, which will be concluded next year, by the way. But yeah, Divine Series Trilogy is one of my favorite trilogy of all time. The first book, City of Stairs, and then the second book is City of Blades, and the third book is City of Miracles. All three are fantastic, and this is kind of like a standalone trilogy. All three books focus on a different main character taking place in a different city, but I loved it so much, all of them. The first book, the second book, the third book, they are all amazing. I love the Divine Series trilogy. Robert Jackson Bennett is one of the few authors who can combine fantasy, sci-fi, urban fantasy, and horror and mystery, all of them into his series. Even though this is still mainly a fantasy series, but seriously, all of them just work so well. Amazing. If you haven't read this series, give it a try. It is incredible. And then the next trilogy on this list is Ash and Sand Trilogy by Richard Nell. The first book is King of Paradise, the second book is Kings of Ash, and the third book is Kings of Heaven. I love this trilogy, and of course, just like Divine Cities and also The Winnowing Flame, this is also still super underrated. This is a self-published fantasy series, one of the best self-published fantasy series out there, and this is a treat for a grimdark fantasy reader or a dark fantasy, call it whatever you want. But this one is absolutely incredible. It has one of the most iconic main characters that I've ever read in fantasy. Not just grimdark fantasy, but the entire fantasy genre. But seriously, Ruka is as iconic as Logan Ninefingers in my opinion. Kings of Paradise was good already, but Kings of Ash and Kings of Heaven, they were on a different level. Honestly, they were absolutely mind-blowing, and the magic system, kind of like a system here, that Richard Nell implemented into this trilogy is so... it's so unique. Yeah, I really love what he's doing with the magic system. I think you should find out for yourself. It is called Groove. Technically, it is a soft magic system, but there are kind of a bit of a rule to it. But again, it's so good. It's just so good. Seriously, read it. Read it. It's amazing. And then series number 5 on this list is a new edition. This is a new trilogy that I just finished within this year. And that is the Rift War Empire Trilogy by Raymond E. Fies and Jenny Ward. Again, just like Lifeship Traders by Robin Hobb that I just mentioned earlier, I think you can read Rift War Empire Trilogy without reading Rift War Saga. I think that's totally possible. Yes, you will indeed miss some implication and you will miss some world-building stuff, but I think you can still enjoy this series to the fullest even if you don't read Rift War Saga. And this series, especially the first book, Daughter of the Empire, and the second book, Servant of the Empire, you know what? All of them. Just all of them. I think having Jenny Wirtz riding along Raymond E. Fies really immensely helped the characterization of the characters. In my opinion, the characterizations in the Rift War Empire trilogy are significantly above Rift War Saga. Seriously. Mara is one of the best heroines that I've ever read in fantasy, and for some of you who have asked me whether I will be creating a list of favorite characters, one day I definitely will. There are so many characters though, I will have to choose carefully. But again, back to this trilogy, this is one of the best political trilogy that I've ever read, especially the first book and the second book. Terrific characterizations, engaging writing, and then brutal politics and espionage. It's all so good. It's utterly brilliant. And this trilogy, in my opinion, is a classic. It stands the test of time and it will continue to do so. Give this series a try. Give this trilogy a read. And series number 4 on this list, it is the First Law Trilogy by Joe Abercrombie. Are you bored yet of me talking about Joe Abercrombie? Because you have to get used to it. I won't be shutting up about his books. That won't happen. Oh yeah, the First Law Trilogy. I will admit that I have a bit of a bias towards this trilogy. But at the same time, I think that's kind of well deserved because this trilogy has probably the best characterizations that I've ever read in grimdark fantasy. Just starting from the Blade itself, Joe Abercrombie has already introduced some of the most iconic characters in fantasy. Again, not just grimdark fantasy, but in the entire fantasy genre. Logan Ninefingers, Sandan Glokta, Bias, those three are some of the most iconic and some of the most memorable characters in modern fantasy. And I think these names will always be remembered. Yeah, Logan Ninefingers is one of my favorite characters of all time, and the same goes for Sandan Glokta as well. and we get to see them for the first time in the First Law trilogy. But besides the characterizations, which is super excellent, the humor on this grimdark fantasy trilogy is just so on point. I can't believe how many times I laugh reading this supposedly a dark fantasy series. And the trilogy keeps on getting better with each installment, in my opinion. The Last Argument of Kings, which is the conclusion to the First Law trilogy, is still, in my opinion, Joe Abercrombie's best book to this day. This is the book that earned Joe Abercrombie the title of Lord Grimdark, in my opinion. And it's definitely up there with his newest book, The Wisdom of Crowds. Both of them are a masterpiece in grimdark fantasy. The Blade itself was released 15 years ago, so yeah, it has been a long time, more than a decade. And if you haven't read this trilogy, I will just say that you are missing out. Give this series a try. Joe Abercrombie is amazing. And then at the number 3 spot, it is The Lycanius Trilogy by James Islington. Yeah, I absolutely love this trilogy. I can't believe how few people actually love this trilogy on BookTube, because this one, in my opinion, deserves so much more love. It is one of the most twisted, complex, and intricate trilogy that I've ever read. And I have mentioned so many times that The Shadow of What Was Lost works so well as an introduction to those who want to start adult fantasy. And yes, I mean it. But again, I want to make sure that you understand that the second book, An Echo of Things to Come, and then the third book, The Light of All That Falls, they improve significantly in difficulty. They improve significantly, and I know that a lot of people have complained that they don't remember enough details about the first and second book to enjoy the third book fully. And this is why I always recommend, when you're going to approach this trilogy, try to binge read them, or at least read them closer to each other. I think that's very important. If I had waited a long time before I read The Light of All That Falls, I don't think I would have enjoyed it that much, because this series is complex. It has so many details. I call it a Malazan Book of the Fallen in smaller format. Seriously. The plotting and worldbuilding is meticulously done, and the writing is so engaging and accessible. And Caden, in my opinion, is one of my favorite characters of all time. I think James Islington did an excellent job with Caden. Such an excellent job. James Islington has also mentioned that after reading The Kingkiller Chronicle by Patrick Rothfuss and also Mistborn Trilogy by Brandon Sanderson, those two inspired him to write this trilogy. And although I can see the Wheel of Time inspirations into this series, I think if you love Mistborn Trilogy too, I think you will love the Lycanius Trilogy. So speaking of Mistborn Trilogy, at the number 2 spot, yes, at the number 2 spot, it is indeed Mistborn Trilogy by Brandon Sanderson. This is the most important trilogy that I've ever read in my life. The most important series. I have a huge bias towards this series, and at any given day, it could just switch to number 1, depending on my mood, seriously. Vin, Ilan, Sazed, Kelsier, Tensun, and so many other characters in the Mistborn trilogy are beloved friends to me, and this is the series that sparked my love for reading adult fantasy novels, and without it, without reading this trilogy, I don't think I will be where I am today. I don't think that will happen. The magic system Allomancy is still to this day my favorite magic system of all time. It is amazing, it is intricate, and with each book, Brandon Sanderson never stopped expanding upon it. And you can see this evolution in Mistborn era too as well. And besides the amazing characterizations and intricate magic system, I also absolutely love the world building. I think it is atmospheric, the city of Lutadel. It's all so vivid in my head. It's so easy to visualize, and Brandon Sanderson's writing is, as always, so accessible. Every time I read his books, it always feels like I'm inside the story immediately. It's so easy. It's just so easy and accessible, and I think that's an amazing thing. And besides that, just like the Lycanius trilogy, the plotting of the entire trilogy is so meticulously done. Believe me, if you're reading Mistborn trilogy for the first time, there will be a lot of mind-blowing revelations and plot twists. And yeah, I absolutely love Mistborn trilogy, and I definitely will be doing a second read of this trilogy again. Probably next year. Yeah, probably next year. And finally, at the number 1 spot, this is the best completed fantasy trilogy that I've read, and I think some of you will know about this already because I haven't shut up about this trilogy for a month now. So this is the Greenbone Saga trilogy by Fonda Lee. I just can't believe that this trilogy is real. It is an amazing epic urban fantasy trilogy. I have done a video on why you should read the Greenbone Saga trilogy by Fonda Lee, so I will link you to the video down below. Oh, and also I also did the why you should read Mistborn trilogy as well, so I will link that also in the description. So back to the Greenbone Saga trilogy here, and I will try to keep this brief. Let me just say that this is truly a masterpiece, the best fantasy trilogy that I've ever read. The characterizations are phenomenal, dialogue and the actions, both of them were incredibly explosive and vivid. and Fondali's writing style clicked with me so well. The first time I read JCD, I thought it was great. And then I read A Jade War, I was so mind blown by that already. So because of that, I decided to reread JCD and Jade War before I read Jade Legacy. And my god, what a worthy decision that was. I became even more connected with the characters. These characters, they are all just so real to me. Kaul, Hilo, Shudon, She, Anden, and so many other characters. They're all so real to me. They're still real to me to this day. And I will always remember their journey, their struggle, everything about this trilogy. I will always remember them. This is a true masterpiece. This entire trilogy is a true masterpiece. And Jade Legacy is one of the best books of all time. And this trilogy, The Green Bone Saga, is the best completed fantasy trilogy that I've read so far. Yeah, that's it. What do you think about this list? That's my top 10 completed fantasy trilogy of all time. I will update this list once I've read maybe 10 or 20 completed fantasy trilogy. But in the meantime, this is the top 10 best completed fantasy trilogy that I've read. What do you think about this list? And let me know what's the best completed fantasy trilogy that you've read. As always, thank you so much for watching and thank you for your support. Bye bye.